Hold up.
Okay, so good morning, guys. The topic for the discussion is My India in 2020.
Very good morning to all my dear friends. As you know, all they are here to discuss our GD topics. So I hope you guys will end up and start it with a very peaceful manner. So the GD topic, the today's GD topic is our India in 2020. So as you all know, there are many policies are going on to make our India better. Next is Bharat Abhiyan, Beti Bachao Beti Padhao, very useful and much more. So in my opinion, I think in 2020 our India are going to be made better than now the current state. Also, there are many India is growing very good in manufacturing industries. With the help of these policies like GST, it will give a very good advantage to our manufacturing lines. Like I just did a survey, 10% of tax, just save it from GST, and this 10% of tax will take a better utilization in manufacturing processes. So that's my opinion. Now I would like to hear your thoughts.
To my friend, I really appreciate your viewpoints and I am really very satisfied with your viewpoints. I also want to add my viewpoints as we have stepped up to 2018, but after 2 years in 2020, the India will be more developed than today in the terms of the technical feasibilities and economic parameters. Both are very important for us. Also, the many scopes such as GST, demonetization, also play a vital role in developing our nations. Also, the internet connectivities also make our nation in a broad manner. Also, and the economical connectivities connect us from the farther world. Such as also the ISRO and other space stations are launched many satellites which will achieve the nearly impossible things.
I am agree with the opinions of my friend here. As a sports person, I would like to talk about future sports. Like, we have a new initiative, Khelo India. And in this initiative, the schools are coming forward and with the new curriculum of improving the standard of sports in our country. And by the 2020, we have an Olympic in next year. The country is focusing, we have a population of 131 crore, and we win hardly one or two medals in our Olympics like last year. But a country like America, with a population just equal to Uttar Pradesh, is winning medals in bundles. You know, most of the medals are given by United Nations and China. They are winning because they have a high standard of sports. In India, the standard of sports is very low. And with a new initiative carried out by our Prime Minister, we are looking forward for improving the standard of sports in earlier stages of an individual. Like in our school curriculum, we hardly have a good standard of sports. Hardly one lecture, one period in a week. And it is not in a specific sports, but with the new curriculum, with the talent of individual,
that he has said about the Khelo India program led by the Mr. Narendra Modi. And one more I need to add that Mr. Narendra Modi not only trying to change our India, but he is also trying to change our thoughts about what we are thinking about our systems and our society. He is also trying to change the international view for us. You can say that the companies around the world, now they are seeking India as a great opportunities platform. And this fact, we can say that Make in India, now he is upgrading Make in India by placing it by Make by India. Actually, he is trying to have, or we can say, invite the other internationals, opportunities or other companies to come in India and make their equipment for whatsoever they want to do. And by this way, the mentality of the Indian peoples can also be changed, and we can also be helpful to upgrade ourselves by so that we can compete throughout the world.
I partially agree with my friend's point of view, but I have different point of opinion that in these type of policies, the rich and the middle peoples are gaining profit, that they are getting opportunities of different type of things in GST and in net banking, etc. policies. But what about the people that are not able to get their children to school? The poor people are not able to send their children to school, so how would they participate in the trend according to the policy, Khelo India? And in India, we come to know that most of the talents are found in our roads or gullies, whatever say. So some sort of things should be done so that everyone could take the benefit of this talent.
You are talking about poor people. If a chai wala can be your prime minister, then my friend, everything is possible.
Yes.
And you know, if you think about a middle class family, the most of the time the person who gets success is either a rich person or a poor person. Because middle class family, you know, there is a हमारा होता है ना कि कहते हैं जो पढ़ाई कर पढ़ाई कर खेलना मिलना मत कर बट जो पुअर होता है रिच होता है उनका ये है कि या तो खेल या पढ़ या तो खेल या तो पढ़ पैसा तो है ही उनके पास
लोटस इज ऑलवेज खाना सो वी कैन से दैट माय फ्रेंड दैट आई एग्री दैट यू गॉट अ पॉइंट नाउ लेट वी जस्ट बाय सम कमर्शियल प्रोडक्ट्स सो देयर आर लिटिल बिट टैक्स लिटिल बिट फंड वन गोइंग फॉर दोस चाइल्ड्स And also there are the 25% reserved seats for those people, those slums children who just want to achieve their goals. So policies are going on. For our government can taking the everything. They are observing everything and they just making their policies according to that.
But at that point, I totally disagree. Nowadays, everyone is getting a certificate of the such quotas. A general person nowadays, if there are 100 vacancies, now only 20 vacancies are available only for generals, 18 are for reserved for SC, ST or OBCs, and the generals are moving to make certificates, fake certificates, so some sort of action should be taken so that the reserved persons only get this type of jobs
and
vacancies.
As you said that the discrimination in our society is just because of the politicians. They are not going to want us to develop our minds and think. As you know, the first initiative of our Prime Minister is Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, and he passed a statement from Lal Qila that if 1.1 crore people think of make their mind that no one that they are not going to. What you can say that they are not going to litter their places or clean up their home society. So no one in this world can change or make our India, what you can say, more dirty or something like that. So what we is trying to say is trying to make our changes in our mind.
Actually, I am totally against this. As we can see, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan movement is, I think. It's not being so popular as people are not following at all, as you can see, just for gaining their popularity or fame, they are doing Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. And Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is, I think, a successful movement for Mr. Narendra Modi. That's why I don't think so.
Maybe you are right, but friend, I don't have an opinion. It depends upon us that how we tackle the situation. Just like you said that the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, you said that the Narendra Modi in speech that he addressed that the if we 1.3 we all 121 crore people we all think in our mind that we can clean our places and don't litter the waste and don't garbage in everywhere, and we can also change the mind and mentalities of others. Then no one will be in our nation that make our places dirty and it depends on our mentality. It is maybe, as you said, that the general people's general category people's have it is possible that they may not have any resources to reach us, but the changes makes time.
As per my opinion, the policies are long, are good for them, good for us, but they will be more successful if we talk about them on a micro level, not on a mass level. That is Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is more successful if every one of us takes our big participate on ourselves, that I will not throw a generator or something on the roads or other things. It will not help if the government takes this on the mass level.
I would like to add some points of your that point of view that you said there is something that some people don't get enough links opportunities to get their education. Well, I agree with you, but there was a parcel. Now recent that government has taken a step first of all, in past there is a manual lottery for those students, but right now there are the already a computerized lottery to which been given the name of the students. So I don't think we can mess with the computerized system. Also, the government has very sharp eyes on those policies. So now the things has changed.
Okay, so can we conclude?
I would like to change the topic here.
Can we conclude?
I can conclude.
Okay.
And go to demonetization. With the initiative of demonetization, you know, the corruption level decreases on a mass scale. Due to this reason, you know, India is not a poor country. India is a rich country. When a chaprasi can, you know, do a corruption of crores rupees, then if we invest that money on a social welfare, you know, making roads, you know, building structures and all these sort of things, then the level of our country will increase, and the manufacturing rate will increase, the rate of labors, you know, employment level will increase, and you know, with all the initiatives taken by our Prime Minister and the people, high command people, you know, they are very powerful with their brain, and they are, you know, doing something for our country. And we don't want a situation in our country like in America, when in 1930s that all the jobs were gone. You know, we want to create an environment for our, in our country like that every person is employed, and the level of GDP of our country increases, and you know, it is estimated that the youth of our country is, you know, learning new things, you know, advancement, new technologies. You know, we are developing things that are, you know, different from other countries. The level of handwork in our country is at the highest level in all over the world. The, you know, structures we are making, you know, the monuments we have, the art we have, the literature we have is world famous. And the other people, the yoga in our country, we give yoga to other countries, and we are the motivators of fitness. You know, other countries are learning these things now. We are learning from, you know, past 800,000 years. And if you talk about, you know, in 2020, what I expect from my country, I expect the, you know, with all the new initiatives like Hum Do Humara Do, we can have a slight control in our population level, and we can build, you know, slum areas. We can build, you know, pakka makan, you know, solid houses. Now we have basti type system. जब भी कोई minister आता है तो बस्ती हटाई जाती है, वो साफ करा दी जाता है कुछ देर के लिए. Now we can create, you know, पक्का मकान बना सकते हैं उनके लिए. We can fulfill. Now we have a potential that we can fulfill the basic need of food, shelter, and roti kapda aur makan to each and every person of our country. And right now we have a, you know, poverty level of around 40% in our country. Only 60% person is, you know, enjoying all the facilities we are having in our country. We have right to speak. We have right to put forward our thoughts. You know, this is not possible in any other country. Not in China, not in North Korea, not in even America. Now here, you know, people talk about everything. People talk rubbish. People talk something good, and everyone has right. But in my personal opinion, I think in 2020 there should be a particular, you know, decorum. When you speak in public areas, you need to respect the morality of your country. You should not talk about your country, which is, you know, which is insignificant thoughts, which are making, you know, which are making a bad image of our country towards other countries. You know, there are some people, they are, you know, some people who have that thought ki ye to, you know, hamare bhag to sab hota hai ya sab aise hi hota hai. But we have a, you know, we have a rich history. The amount of freedom we have in this country, there is no amount of freedom in any other country all over the world. Nowhere. The amount of freedom we have here to each and every religion, to each and every caste, creed, etc. The amount of freedom we have, we should, you know, we should be thankful to our government, our nation, that we are having such kind of freedom. You know, other countries, just for, you know, spreading you are fined, you are jailed. There are other things, you know, that just for, you know, speaking something rubbish, and you are getting punished, you are getting, you know, violated. All these kind of thoughts. And one more thing, we have a, you know, high rate of rapes in our country, and there should be a mandatory law, in my opinion, should be made, so that the punishment of rape, after full inquiry, if the person is, you know, convicted that he did it, he should be sentenced to death, in my opinion. And that's the after full inquiry, not in a hurry manner. After full inquiry, the punishment of rape should be death. And these are some things which I see that India will try to change in 2020. And I hope the next year is 2019 World Cup and India will win it. Thank you.
Okay, great.
Conclusion is that, like, I accept that we are not going to get 100% developed at 2020, but I guess more than 50% we can achieve our growth in every every area, every zone, and with respect of these policies going on right now, they will hopefully give us a better result. Thank you. Hold up.